Okay, in today's session, we are going to see some popular libraries to analyze and download financial data from different resources. I think yesterday and yesterday's sessions, you have seen a highlight of how you can retrieve or extract financial data with Keroad, right? I'm sure you utilize Y Finance to get the financial data from Yahoo Finance. I'll show you simple extraction method. It's the straightforward, and mainly I will show you how we can analyze financial data by leveraging TA-Lib and Pyfolio for portfolio analysis. So let me share my screen and we will start. I prepare a very short slide first to familiarize you with these libraries. Is my screen visible for you all? Okay, thank you guys. Since I'm not able to see you writing or hands, if you raise your hands, please open your mic. And if you have any question in the middle, open your mic and just ask me, okay? This session is on introductory session on Y Finance, Finance and TA-Lib and Pyfolio for portfolio analysis. Just to give you insights, Python became a leading choice for financial data analysis due to its simplicity, and it's because it supports powerful libraries that can be used, that can be leveraged to use for this analysis. The popular ones on financial analysis are Y Finance, TA-Lib, and Pyfolio for portfolio analysis. Some of the applications are to see the performance of the DATS financial data or the company, and to manage our risk and to visualize and report our data. There are a lot of applications, but these are the few that I mentioned here. You can go and browse more. Y Finance, as you've seen yesterday, it's a popular library that allows users to download and access this data from a popular Yahoo Finance database. There are a lot of lot of companies data are stored there, and we can extract that data and see the performance and further analysis. For our analysis, the popular library we use here is TA-Lib. It's a Python library that provides a wide range of technical indicators analysis. It supports more than 115. It can analysis for financial data indicators like SME, RSI. You can see it. You will see it on my demo, which will give some insightful information about that data and the performance of that company. Pyfolio is a library that provides tool for portfolio analysis for investment, mainly for maximizing investment and risk evaluation. If you have multiple companies and we want to invest on those companies, and we want to know which what segment or what amount of money we should allocate for these companies, we are going to perform some portfolio analysis, and I'm going to show you some of that. Y Finance, as you've seen, I'm not going to repeat that. It's a popular library for downloading and accessing deep data. And the reason it's popular is it integrates with popular libraries like TA-Lib. The key features are it makes data access for all easy, and its installation is, as you can see, it's people install Y Finance, it's easy. TA-Lib is the one that we are going to perform our analysis on. It's provide wide range of analysis for technical indicators, and support a lot of more than 150 indicators, trend analysis, signal generation, and market timing. We can these are the key features for PLIP. Portfolio, as I told you, performance metrics, risk analysis, and visualization. We use that for visualization to calculate the weight of the portfolio. We will see what weight is, and how we can interpret the performance, the portfolio performance. It's easy to install, like pip install and portfolio. So we'll install it. By combining these three and other, there are other, these are what the one that we picked. There are other libraries too. We can easily access and analyze large amount of financial data and calculate these technical indicators. These allow to develop trading strategy and make prediction about future market movement for investment risk and for financial analysts. This information will be handful. The resources, here the I think that the part that we will have a little struggle on will be a part that you will install on PLIP. I put on some installation videos and guides here, but there are some dependency issues with PLIP. It supports downgraded NumPy, and to use that NumPy, you have to downgrade your pandas package too. These are the one that work for me. The NumPy that 1.21 works for me, and for the pandas, this work for me. But try to follow these videos where installing TLib, and if you have any question, we can guide you. This is my presentation. If you have any question here, we can raise it before I move to my demo. And Dufa, continue.
Isamar?
Yeah.
Okay, my question is since all those libraries are specific to the project, mm-hmm. Do we create a virtual environment to do our project, or we use the actual Python environment?
One thing should be clear here. The reason that we use virtual environment in our project is to isolate our project dependencies from the global one. Because, for example, in here, we need a downgraded, not updated NumPy and pandas. But for other analysis, we might need updated version of these libraries, right? So if we put that on the global one, you won't be able to use that. But for this specific project, we are going to create some virtual environment and install these all libraries on that virtual environment to isolate it from our other projects. For our other projects too, it's better. It's always advisable to use these virtual environments within our project, because every project will require certain its own dependency, and to avoid any conflict between dependencies on the libraries, it's better to use the virtual environment within our, that's specific to our environment. So
okay,
what if I use Docker? When you do Dockerize, you're going to use these libraries that you specify on your project. So this even will be helpful for later use on the Dockerization and deployment. That's why we specify these environments for these specific projects. Just continue.
So task one and task two lie, you lay a virtual environment create Maragal Leben Maletno. That task one lie, Idiones around a bit virtual environment like Pipum, Pandown, all are updated version.
The reason that I stated here is because even I was having some issue on dependencies on these libraries. The one thing that will block is using by using this downgraded pandas and numpy libraries is you are unable to use I think matplotlib. So I used plotlib for my visualization purpose. So it's better, you can downgrade it. Most of the functionalities using pandas will be there, but other libraries like matplotlib might require updated ones or the versions that are start from certain version. So for that, the one that I used is plotlib for visualization. There might be other libraries that require the updated one. We will handle it during the week if certain conflicts arise, but you can downgrade it.
So starting from task one, let us start try to install this thing and now download and downgrade argan hulunum start with another.
That's my advice.
Okay, so every plot in this project the plot d mess rat palette.
This is the solution that I came up with, but okay. You can try, for example, the matplotlib need I think 1.25 bohala no mesela yifalgo. So you can try those libraries if it works with tlib, but most of the people will have hard time installing it. How many people use Linux here? Are you guys all using Windows?
Most probably, yeah.
I guess mostly Windows.
Windows, yeah. So there are certain steps you have to go through on installing tlib. I put a video and brought for yourself too, okay? On installation part, and if you have hard time, we can you can reach me out or any other tutors on Slack. So let me go to my demo. If there is no any question, there is one, we can address it here. So can you see my screen? Most of you guys were raising question on why do we need a PY file and a PYNV file. So here I try to show you to make my code modular and object-oriented. I put most of my functions inside this class, Financial Analyzer class. It's, as you can see, I put it in scripts, the directory with init.py. This is, I see some people raising question about init. This is the way we make this file a Python package, and we can call it anywhere on outside inside our project and use these all functions that we created here in some other place on the project. So the first thing I declare is, as you seen yesterday, this is a class and its inheritance. I'm sure you're familiar with that, or we can go through that, how we can declare a class. Within a class, we have these methods. The first one is we retrieve stock data. As you see yesterday, it's a simple instruction like wife. I imported wife finance as wife here. So dot download. These tickets I'm going to pass as an argument for this class where I instantiate. I'll show you later. But this ticker is a symbol for that company we are interested one with for our analysis. And this is but for this project, you don't have to download. If you have hard time on downloading, you don't have to do that. Just we provide you the data, but it's better to see how you can extract the data. I'll show you how I extracted the data and give you, this is the data extraction function that I write for you last time to extract the data. I specify the tickers for all these 7 companies, and I specify the period to be maximum from earliest to the latest one to be that. And we simple, this is the simple saving instruction to save it some where in my directory I will give you this code, but it's very easy to extract one. So in this this is the first methods. I begin using the TA-lib to calculate SMA. SMA is a simple moving average. It's perform a simple moving average for a period of time that we specify. It calculates the average price during that period. This is the instruction. The instruction is as easy as TA SMA.SMA, and we pass the data and the time period with it. But since we pass it where we instantiate the class, we don't have to do that here. So then I try to calculate some. This is a simple for only SMA, but then I try to calculate this all financial indicators. These are the most common financial indicators, but you can go through. I will show you where you can get these indicators, the list of indicators. TA supports a lot of indicators. These are simple moving average. This is risk risk strength index. This one is exponential moving average, and you can go through all this, and they will provide you a meaningful insight about the data. And as you can see, it's for EMA, it's TA.EMA. It's easy instruction. Then I try to plot these data. For example, on the data we retrieve, there will be a close, open, adjacent close, low and high parameters. They have their own meaning. I'm sure you are introduced with that yesterday. Then I try to plot the RSI. These are my plotting function. It's simple, px dot imported plotly as px, and I plot these extracted indicators. I will show you how you can plot it. These are my functions. I'm going to use these functions inside my notebook. I will show you that. This is my portfolio analysis. I try to I will accept some tickers, start date and end date, and I will try to calculate the weight. The weight, I will show you what it means, the weight of the portfolio. And here, portfolio return, portfolio variability, and shape ratio. I try to retrieve that using this library, PIFO. This is it. I will give you this code so you will see it. These are simple functions that are declared on my Python scripts folder. So I'm going to call these all functions to in my notebook for later and use that. So let's go to that. If you have question in the meantime, you can raise it. I'm not showing the screen. You can open up your mic and speak if you have any question. Okay.
Elias, yeah. My question is, in your function or in one of your functions, okay, you have a retriever of the data, right?
Yes, just to show you guys how you can retrieve by declaring the function, but you don't have to. You can load the function, the data you have, and further proceed with your analysis. You don't have to do that. Just if you want to, for example, if you are going to use the data after a month, you have to get the latest financial information, right? In that time, you should retrieve another one for a month. So that's why you have to know how it's very easy to extract the financial data from Yahoo Finance. That's why I put it in my code. But you are provided with the data, you can use it, but try to extract one. It's very easy.
All right, thank you.
So this is my notebook. most of you guys were having difficulty to set this directory. Here I try to declare a directory where when I import the Python file, where to, I'm declaring where the this notebook should point out. So for example, in week one, this all are in week one, right? I get the current working files directory, then it's on notebook, right? Then I try to get the where the notebook is located using the parent directory, then the notebook is located within week one. So it will go to week one and try to import this module, because I make it init, because we make it init.py, we declare it as a Python function. We don't have any difficulty to import it, as you can see. So this is not, this is the list of the, this I include before you just, there is a site on Wikipedia, you can read with pandas read HTML, the list of tickers available. These are the heads. And if we can see the shape, there are 503 tickers with the symbol. The one that we are interested in here is the symbols that we can use for our retrieval. Then there are Yahoo Finance, but it's going to take some time. I'm not going to run it, and I'll show you there. This is just, for example, if I retrieve a Microsoft's the data, and I want to show you in plots just for the visualization. The one that we put on the py file, the class started here. Here we retrieve open, close, high, and low. And as you can see, I try to visualize it like this. That's not a big deal. Here I initialize, as you can see. This is my financial analyzer, right? It expects a ticker, a start date, and end date. So I initialize it with, since it's going to retrieve, I put a retrieval extracting function. I pass some ticker, but you don't have to. You can modify the class. And I put some starting and ending dates for that. So if I run this, it will run. It creates an instance of that class here in my notebook. So I declare a retrieve stock function here, right? Retrieve stock. It will download a ticker that passed to it. So as you can see, analyzer, I create the instance with the name analyzer. So analyzer.create stock market. And if I run this, it will retrieve some of this data, open, high, low, close, adjacent volume. Open is, I'm sure you introduce open is the opening price of that stock. For example, we are seeing upper right. What's the opening price on that day? If you know stock exchange, there is variation in price for opening each day or specific time. Most of the time, it's set on each day. So open price is the open price for that day. High is the high price that's sold, the highest price that was sold during this period. The low is the lowest price that was sold in this period. The close is the closing date. On this day, the closing price was this. This will be helpful on the opening of the next day. And adjacent clause is the one that they paid for the dividend and splitting purpose. The volume is the amount of share that was sold on that specific day. These are the parameters that we just extracted from that Y finance. Then the another function we have is calculate technical indicator, right? On technical indicator, we expect to give us SMA, RSA, EMA, MSD, and this five indicators. They all have their meanings. If I run this, they will give me this. Our table was up to volume, but it adds these five parameters. SMA is just simple moving average for that day. It will, for specific day, or it might be for 12 day or 26 day, it gives an average of that price. RSI is relative spending index. It evaluates what overbought. There are terms called. You have to on while finalizing this talk analysis, you have to go through these financial terms. These all things you can get, I think, here. There are more than 115, I think, indicators, and they all have their own meaning. You can go through them, but I listed some of them here. SMA is simple moving average. RSA is, it will tell you the oversell and overbought price. For example, if most of the time, if the RSI is more than 17, in this case, it will consider as overbought. Overbought means there are a lot of needs, right? It's best time to sell your stock on that day. If it's less than 20, most of the time, it's the best time to buy. There is an oversold, so they have meaning. Go through some of the data. I'm sure you will go through some of them while your analysis. MACD is moving average, convergence, divergence. It will give you, it will pick two AMI. AMI means exponential moving average. It will try to follow more recent data. So MACD will calculate two AMI, for example. It might be, for example, 12 day and 26 day. AMI, it will calculate the exponential mean of that price for 12 day and 26 day, and it try to make some relation to give you some insight about that. MAC, this with signal is, it will calculate the 9 day average and potential buy and selling ticket signal. It's at actual mal no. It will give you potential buying and selling signal, but you have to go through them. This is simple, and you can browse. So I try to plot some stock data here. I specify this function here. It will plot a closing value with SMA. So if you can see, this is the SMA. The red one is the SMA, and the purple one is the closing price. Here, RSI, I try to visualize RSI, for example, here it's 28. So it might be give you signal to buy. And in here, if you can see, it's more around 18, it might give you signal to sell. They have their own meaning. You can go through them. This is how you can visualize them. This is if I want to plot the whole. Okay, this is a repetition, I think. Okay, plot MC. This is to plot this function. Plot MACD with MACD signal. So if we can see it. Since the MACD signal is a nine day average of it. It will be lagged with some days with that, but it will try to follow and have a meaningful. The reason we analyze for 9 days, for 10 days is it's not easy to just to say a lot of things with just 1 day performance of the stock or any data, right? So here we, is it clear so far? Do you have any question? Okay, let me proceed. Portfolio analysis, I instantiate, we don't need that here. Just for the period of 2000, we can do for 2020. We're going to calculate the weight. The weight means if you want to, for example, if you have some money and you want to invest on stock of Apple, Google, or Microsoft, how should you divide your money based on that? For example, if you have $100 and if you want to invest on three companies and they will give you 0.4, 0.3 and 0.3. It means you have to invest 14, 13 and $13 in each of them. For example, let's see a portfolio for this. As you know, Tesla performed lately better than these companies. So because Tesla's stock dominance was very much during this time, it's better, it's giving one for Tesla, it's better to invest on all on Tesla during this time. That's it's telling you the weight. It will analyze the performance of all this and it will give you some value. For example, if it was 0.4, 0.4 and 0.4, 0.3 and 0.3, it means 30%, 40% and 30% respectively, the weights. Here are the other portfolio parameters, like portfolio return, portfolio variability and shape ratio. For example, if you want to, for this three company, portfolio return means 0.785. That means, for example, overall gain or loss, you can get 0.7%, 8% if you invest on these three companies during this time. A portfolio variability, there is a 0.47% variability on the fluctuation on this portfolio return. This one will calculate the variability of portfolio return. Shape ratio, it means excess return per year. For a risk you are taking, what excess return can you get? It consider both portfolios and return in variable. It will use this both in consideration while performance. You can go in depth what these terms, and you can add any other parameters during your analysis. But this is the one that I prepare for you. So this is all from my demo. Before I close my demonstration, if you have any question on any specific points during the session, you can raise it here. Is it confusing? Okay, from the chat, the why technical data feature are not clear to my, could you say something? Why technical data, what does it mean, Balaina? I didn't get that.
Yeah, there's a man at the level of the
machine.
Network, Lola Chumo? I summoned him, say?
Okay,
these parameters that I said, as I told you, TA Lib has a lot of more than 115, I think, according to my browsing, parameters to be used on our data to have some insight about the data that we are using. For example, SMA, the one we use is here. Simple moving, this is a document, their site, simple moving average. It will give you an average of the price for that period. For example, if you are looking for 12 day, it will see the average of the price during that time. This SMA. But most of the parameters that I use, I just told you for my demo, you have to browse and learn a lot more about them. But the one that I used, Nazin Noel Coral, Belen, RSI. Normally you can write some function for this, but TALib has more than 115 financial indicators. But these all financial indicators are already TALib handle other actual. How does it yes, are you actual lot hand TALib miss at shown international financial indicator of natural? Nazil Yagabachu, the finance analysis say እንትን ምን ማለት እንደሆነ ያያያችሁ ይጠቅመኛል ብላችሁ የምታስቡት ፎር ኤግዛምፕል ምንድነው ኒውስ አላችሁ ኒውሱን ሴንቲመንት አውጡለት አላችሁ አይደል ከሴንቲመንቱ ላይ based on that sentiment እንዴት ነው ፋይናንሻል ፐርፎርማንሱን አፌክት ያደረገው ነው ምናም ኮሬሌሽን ልትሰሩ ነው አይደል so what will you do is you have to know the performance of that stock or specific company's stock right so you will use these parameters to analyze how it's doing if it's doing bad and you will see the news and there was a bad news about that data you will correlate this to but to know the performance you have to use these parameters SMA በራሳችን ሳይሆን እነዚህ TLB-ን እንድትጠቀሙ የተፈለገው ለዚህ ነው ቢዩልቲን የሆኑ ፋይናንሻል አናሊሲስ ለመስራት የሚጠቅሙ ብዙ ኢንዲኬተሮች አሉት RSI the one that I use relative strength index ምንድነው የሚነግረው ቀደም እንዳልኳችሁ ለምሳሌ will evaluate overbought እና በጣም ብዙ የተገዛና በጣም ብዙ ተገዛ ማለት will have price ከፍ ይላል ለማንኛውም market so it's the best time to sell ለማድረግ ያለህን stock ለምሳሌ best time ሊሆን ይችላል it will give you signals like this እንደዚህ አይነት አናሊሲሶችን ለመስራት built-in የሆኑ እንደዚህ አይነት ኢንዲኬተሮች አሉት MACD ለምሳሌ moving average convergence divergence it will take exponential moving average-ን ይወስድና የሁለት term ለምሳሌ የ12 ቀን እና የ6 ቀን ሊሆን ይችላል ለሁለቱ relation ይፈጥራል ለምንድነው it will try to see the 12 day and 26 day performance the longer performance-ን analyze ባረጋችሁት ቁጥር stability-ው ምናምን ይነግራል ስለዚህ እነዚህ ቱሎች እንዳለ ፋይናንሻል ኢንዲኬተሩ ፋይናንሻል ዳታው how is it performing የሚለውን ለማየት ነው እና built-in functions ናቸው አሳይ እስኪ እዚህ ጋር ነው ያስቀመጥኩት TA dot ያረኩ እነሱ ነው ማስቀምጣቸው RSI MI TA dot MCD MCD this signal because they are all listed here
እነሱ ሊንክ ተራ ካስቀምጥልናል ይሄ ዶክመንቱ ይሄንስ
አለ ይሄው እንትኑ ላይ ስላይዱ ላይ አርገላችኋለሁ እዚህ ላይ ማለት ነው መጀመሪያ አይ ቲንክ እሱ ነው አህ እሱ ነው አስቀምጬላችኋለሁ if you have any other question you can write it Ital charotaw yeah you are right you can't decide on using only one indicator it's better to analyze it using a lot of indicators and try to come up with much generalized understanding of the situation so try to browse and see a lot of indicators and try to make conclusion based on multiple indicators as it must to use plotly instead of I mentioned that because in my case I use here numpy 0.1.21 ይጣቀምኩ pandas 1.3 ነው ይጣቀምኩ ምንድነው numpy-ን downgrade ሳደርገው pandas updated pandas numpy-ም ከፍ ያለ ይፈልጋል so I downgraded pandas intern demo matplotlib ልጠቀምሰል pandas 1.25 መሰለኝ በላይ ፈልጋለሁ ሲለኝ ተውኩትና በplotlib ሄድኩኝ ግን if it works tlib በ1.25 እና ከዛ በላይ ባሉት numpy versions ከሰራላችሁ try to install them and use pandas but the main thing is እንደውም ባለፈው matplotlib በደንብ ከተጠቀማችሁ plotlib ደግሞ አሁን በደንብ መጠቀማችሁ it's advisable to know a lot of tools but that's for my case this there is recording it yetederege no so will be available soon as I can okay is there any other question ppt I'll put it in your technical content of the week 1 right away akattwalloñ ppt okay any other question Do you get how you use these functions modular? Abraham, are you here?
Abit.
Did you see how I use this py file in my IPYNV?
አዎ የተወሰነ አይቻለሁ ስክሪፕቶች እንዴት እንደተጠቀምካቸው ፋንክሽኖችን ነው ኮላ ያካቸው አይደል
ስክሪፕቱን ካጣፍከ በኋላ init.py ትላንት ትሉት የነበሩት ስታደርጉት that will make it a python package ያደርጋል ያንን ነገር if i have multiple notebooks here ብዙ ቢኖርኝ you don't have to ባለፈው እንዳልኳችሁ the principle is you don't have to repeat yourself አንዴ የጻፍከውን ኮድ ሌላም ቦታ ራሱን መጻፍ is not efficient so you will write one code and make it modular any other bota toast import ያደረክ መጠቀም እንደትችል ነው ስለዚህ that's how you do it
እስኪ የተወሰነ እስኪ ነው ዘው ግባ እስኪ ኮዱ ጋር
here I declare my functions here so this init.py this is my folder structure first it's a notebook this is script right these are other files and in the scripts I have init.py this is the one that will be created whenever you import this function it's like cache the memory is it's not, I didn't create this one whenever you import it some log will be stored here so I put init.py in scripts this is to make this script folder a python package so if I go to financial analysis and script.financialanalyzer right script.financialanalyzer this is the file this is the directory
yeah
what did we do on while when we import for example let me for plotly is some param package within plotly there is an express plotly.express this is a built-in plotly package as we imported like this እዚጋ ምንድን ያደረግነው this script እንትን ውስጥ ያጣፍነውን ነገር package ያደረግነው we can import it like we do on plotly script.financialanalyzer from that this is our class the class that financial analyzer right this is a class that I wrote so I imported the class so I can use any method that I wrote in this class so if I add any notebook you can create another py file here for example only for plotting function you can have one py file you can call that function only for plotting purpose this is how you manage your code
okay la data on katta ya nabeko ወይስ እሱ ጋር ሎድ አድርገዋል
data reading the only problem ani intern yaderakku download yarakun yesarraw gin the only problem you might have is directory issue no linorabachu michilo for example ani ahon kullu gize ezi week 1 lay set argewallo aralle week 1 lay data mil allay wi finance mil alla
nay finance suga git ignore lay no menaskemto data chinna linya lana lay sim tetekambetalle
yes git ignore ya
ውስናረው ግን አይወጣም እና ከጊት ኢግኖር ጋር እንዴት አድርገን እንደምናነበው ልክ እንደዚሁ
ከጊት ኢግኖር ሳይሆን መታነበው ከዳይሬክቶሪ ነው መታነበው
ና
ታግ ጊት ኢግኖር ፋይል ፑሽ ስታደርግ ያንን ፋይል ኢግኖር እንዲያደርግልህ ነው አንደኛ ብዙ ፋይል ሜይንሊ ዳታ ካምፓኒ ስፔሲፊክ እንትን ሊሆኑ ይችላሉ ስፔስ ፕራክቲስ ኖት ቱ ፑሽ ዳታ ሁለተኛ ደግሞ even open source የሆነ ነገር ሆኖ push ለማድረግ ተስቡ ትልቅ ፋይል ነው እንት ባለፈው ስታዩ እንደነበሩት ሳይዛቸው ትልልቅ ነው የሚሆነው ስለዚህ it's better not to include data so you will ignore it while pushing even statusን checks ስታደርግ git ignore ውስጥ ከተቀመጠ git status ስትለው ያንን እንትን አያመጣው ስለዚህ ignore ነው የሚያደርገው ማለት ነው git ignore ውስጥ ስታስቀምጥ
ታዲያ እኛ ካልተጠቀምንበት ምንድነው ጥቅሙ ጊት ኢግኖር ጋር አስቀምጠን ፑሽ ማረጋች
ኖ ዩ ካን ዳይሬክቶሪውን ዳታ ሚሎን ፋይል ውስጥ ኮል ያደረክ እንት ማለት ይችላል ጊት ኢግኖር ግን ሪሞት ላይ እንዳይሄድ ነው ገባ ሪፖዚቶሪ ላይ እንዳይሄድ እንጂ አናሊሲስ ላይ ጠቅላላ ኮል ያደረክ ትሰራበታለህ ግን ignore ስታደርጎ ወደ ሪፖዚተሪ ወደ ፐብሊክ እንትን አይሄድም ማለት ነው ያ ዳታ because secure እንትን privacy issue ምናምን ሊኖርበት ስለሚችል plus አንዳንድ ደግሞ ትልልቅ ሳይዝም ሊኖራቸው ይችላል mainly ግን it's not advisable it's not best practice to push the data in your repo
ማለት ዳይሬክት ካነበብ ነው እንዴት ይሄዳል ብዬ ነው እኔማ ዳይሬክት ካነበብ ነው እዚህ ጋር ካለመጣ
any folder you put ከሪፖዚተሪ ጋር የተቀመጠ ያነበዋል ይሄዳል እንትን ካልከው ግን we can have a private slack ላይ ማውራት እንችላለን ስለዚህ time can must any other question okay continue who was the hello can
me targe mo targe wal tagaregi
is samale na
yeah
okay thank you ela nem nde ndabram tinis intanalenyna
ah
yeah ane ndalafa kwenten kodochin mulu notebook la no tsipatye nderna
አህ
ካፓይተን ስክሪፕት ወደ ኖትቡክ እንዴት ኮል ያረግን ፋንክሽኖችን ኢንተግሬት አድርገን እንድንጠቀም አሁን የሰራህበትን የዚ ሪፖዚተሪ ሊንክ ወደ እንትን አብራሃታችሁ ታረግልን እና በደንብ እንደምናስተው
እሺ እሺ አውሉ ደ
ኦኬ
ሶርስና ስክሪፕት ለሚለው ሞር ስታንዳርድ እንትን ለዴፊኒሽን ለማምጣት ነው ግን you can use source ብዙ ጊዜ application አሁን ለምሳሌ if you see a react application or ምናም እንደፈነ ነገሮች ላይ source code ለማስቀመጥ ነው ምናስቀምጥበት script ግን execute የሚደረጉ የሆነ ቦታ execute እየተደረጉ I was trying to look into what's ብዙ ጊዜ ምንድነው ለአፕሊኬሽናችን ኮር የሆኑ ሶርሶችን እናስቀምጥበት ወይንም ደግሞ ፕሮግራሚንግ ላንጉጅ ፋይል ኮንፊግሬሽን ፋይል ምናምን እናስቀምጠው እዛኛው ላይ ነው ኮምፓይል ኢንተርፕሬት የሚደረጉ እንትኖች እነዚህ ስክሪፕት ላይ ግን የሆነ ቦታ እንደ ሞጁል ኦር እንደ ላይብረሪ እንደ ፓኬጅ ኢምፖርት ያደረግን ኤክስኪዩት የምናደርጋቸው ነው በት ለአሁን ለፒዩአይ ፋይላችሁ ስክሪፕት ስም ተጠቀሙ if you are going to develop an app for that specific thing then source below la app ትጠቀሙትን front end ላይ ትንሽ ለምድ ያለው ለምሳሌ react ላይ ምናም source ነው የምንጠቀመው the source code for the application you are going to use and now I was trying to use the main difference that's for this to call notebookachu ላይ call ለማድረግ እንትኑ try to use scripts ተጠቀሙ application ምናም ካለ source ተጠቀሙ but there is no much difference I just look it up አሁን ያየሁት ነው if you have question you can continue Mesgana okay. I don't think it's Mesgana okay often Afghana capital
ኦፍጋ
ማን ነው ስም እንገረን አንዴ
ኦፍጋ
ኦኬ ሶሪ
ዳት ዳዝማ ኦኬ ኤልስ ላይክ ላይክ ዊ አር ሃፒ ፎር ሃቪንግ ዩ ሂር ማን ማለት ፈልጋለሁ ነው ጀስት ቪዲዮዎች አሁን እዚ ሪኮርድ ተደርጎ እዛ ዩቲዩብ ላይ ሲለቀቅ እዛ ፋይንዲንግ ነው የሚሆነው አሁን እኔ ትላንት ሴሽኑን አቴንድ አላደረኩም ነበር ከዛ ፈልጌ ነው ያገኘሁት so like what if you guys like create a channel on slack for resources then we can like go through from that what do you think
ሊንኮቹን ዩቲዩብ ሊንኮቹን ለማስቀመጥ ነው
yeah select like channel create argen then kaza like
okay
katta kaza ninaagne wala
okay but we I think it's the intention hone mendinno
Maybe Elias, to help you on this.
Okay.
Yeah, we're considering that and we're trying to do that. So implement the market more. So like, effective no blend in the corner. Channel lam yeta kafeta no. So consider our canal. No, not a quarrel.
Alright, Daddy. Thank you, Daddy.
Okay. Here, I was the one who asked me about problem Streamlit. Streamlit, since you don't push your data on GitHub, I was seeing your Streamlit app last time. The problem was file location problem. A couple of guys tried to reach me out on this before the submission, and we came up with some solution. We didn't have to download drive last time, but on data room. ዳውንሎደብል ማድረግ ይቻላል ዲሪንግ ኤክስኪዩሽን አፓቹ እንትን ሲል ከዛ እሱን ልክ እንትን ሲያደርግ መጀመሪያ ዳታውን ዳውንሎድ ያደርጋል ማለት ነው ኢትስ ፕራይቬት ኦን ዩር ድራይቭ በት ሊንኩን ታስቀምጡለታላችሁ ዳውንሎደብል ማድረግ ይቻላል ደግሞ ሎድ ሲያደርግ ከዛ እሱን ዳውንሎድ ያደርጋል ቢፎር ኤክስኪዩቲንግ ዩር ስትሪምሊት አፕ እንደዛ ነው ከማፕ ያደረግነው ሶሉሽን በት I'm sure there will be a lot of solutions for this. You can look it up in the internet, but if you don't find one, you can reach me out on Slack and we will try to tackle this problem. So Rafael, I think it's an answer. Yeah, that's what we do last time. This worked out for one or two guys. So you can try that. In the last project, I plugged the data to the, yeah. These guys do that, like that, using that method. So you can use that, or there are several approaches to solve this. As Yabi told you last time, this is a guiding platform, not too much, there is not too much teaching. So you have to go and browse by yourself for a lot of approaches and come up. The community by itself will be will come handy or during these programs. Because everybody will have a lot of approach to solve things. So if you have any blocker, try to write it on the dedicated, try to use dedicated channels within the Slack, the Slack workspace. So ask there, and even we, the tutors and other guys who face the same problem and tackle it with different approach will give you some insight on that. That's how this teaching will go. Okay. Yeah, there will be a lot of approach to solve this issue, Streamlit, and any app development. It's not only Streamlit. You will see some other dashboard and app development during this program. So if you have any question, write it, or if you don't have one, we can wrap it here. Is there any question left? So should we end this session here? Give me some reactions.
Yeah, I get a link. Maybe
okay.
The context in the ሞጁል ኢንስቶል እያደረኩኝ ነበር ቅድም ማትፕሎትሊብ ኢንቫይሮንመንት ክሬት አድርጌ ከዛ ደጋግሞ ፋታል ኢረር ይመጣል እዛ ግራ ገባኝ ተማለት
ኦኬ እንደዚህ አይነት ፕሮብለሞች እዚህ ላይ አሁን እንትን ከምንወስድ ላክልኝ ስክሪንሾቱን ኦር ምናምን እዛ ስላክ ላይ መጠረስ እንችላለን ይሻላል ታይም ብዙ እንዳንወስድ ማለት
ኦኬ
ሲንስ ዩ አር ጎይንግ ቱ ሃቭ I think after 30 minutes, it's better to end it here if you don't have any question regarding my session. So, bye, guys. Thank you for
being active
during the session. Thank you. Bye. Ready, we can stop recording. Okay, Barakat. Okay. I think it's by mistake.